Hey, what's up? Sean T here, and I'm gonna show you 7 great exercises from my new program, Strong Week, that's gonna be sure to get you a stronger core. So let's go. All right, so the first exercise we're gonna do is called the hip up crunch reach, and you have to really stay focused and get ready to push your lower back in to the floor. Pay close attention here. So, arms will be to the side. Make sure your back is nice and flat. First thing you're gonna do is push your heels into the floor and lift your hip up. Now, I want you to squeeze your butt back here, right? Palms down. When you come down, you're just gonna then shoot up so you can really push forward. Lower back into the floor. Make sure you have a fist width between your chin and your chest, and then you come back down nice and slow. Everything is done slow and controlled. So let's do some reps together. So lift and squeeze the booty, come down, reach, exhale on the way up, tighten your core, and then back down. From this point forward, what I want you to do with all of your ab exercises is do them slow and controlled. Don't go too fast, because this is not gonna work. See, your body goes out of position, just lift up, squeeze, down, and push forward. Make sure you exhale on the way up. Let's keep going. Now, if you're doing this for a second time, I expect you to be amazing at what you're doing and really using your core. All right, give me one more good one so you know you have this under control. Hold it up there so you know you can push the lower back into the floor and then come down. All right, so the next exercise we're gonna do is a 3-point crunch. That means your arms are gonna come behind here. Now, usually with crunches, people put their hands behind their head, and what starts to happen is they start to do this, and that does absolutely nothing. Get it? Absolutely nothing. So for this one, we're gonna bring our hands up, biceps by the ear. As you come up, you're gonna bring the front leg up. You're gonna connect the back of your forearm to your knee. Your shoulders on the floor, your lower back is pressed into the floor, and your back heel is into the floor. There's your 3 points of contact. You come down and you go up. Exhale on the way up. In rock climbing, they say have 3 points of contact to keep safety so that you can stay secure. And that's the same thing you're gonna do in this exercise so that you can really burn the core. Give me about 4 more good ones. Really take it nice and slow, like I said before, so you can bring the burn to you. Right now, my abs are burning. It hurts. But you just gotta embrace the goodness. I think I made you do more than 4, but that's fine. Okay, good job. Come down nice and slow as you're feeling the burn. Sit up, and what we're gonna do is now we're gonna go into the running lunge twist. Okay, so check it out. Shoulders, wrist, elbow in line with each other. You're gonna take the back leg forward. Watch this one first before you try, because both feet are coming off the ground at the same time. You're gonna switch over, do a running lunge. I'm looking at you, but make sure your head is in neutral spot. When that leg comes up, you're just gonna twist it up, keeping the core tight, working in the obliques, and come back down and switch to the other side. So keep your head down and try this exercise. Let's do a few reps. Remember, go nice and slow, but go at your own pace. Thinking about this as you switch the legs. When both feet are off the ground, the only thing you can use is your core. So you have to exhale, but you also have to keep that core nice and tight as you push through. Now, this is one exercise that once you get really good at it, you can move just a little bit faster, but you should never do a step, okay? It should always be both feet landing at the same time. Keep going, keep pushing. If I'm sweating, I know you're sweating. So dig deep. This is the last one. And good job. Now you're gonna come down. The next exercise is one of my favorites. It's very simple, but it's very effective for flexibility and core strength. So it's a downward dog. You can put your hands flat. For some reason, I put my hands here because of my wrist. So here we go. You start in a plank position. When you hit the downward dog, you're gonna take that front hand and reach toward the back shin. And then you come down. Make sure your butt's not in the air. Make sure you push through, weight in the heels, and go to the other side, touching the shin. Now, as you're doing this, you wanna really tighten your abs. Exhale, whenever you close your body, you exhale. Give me a few more, breathe through. You're probably shaking right now, but it's all good. Keep going, 4, exhale, bring the butt down, tuck the hips under, 3, exhale, tuck the hips under, 2, exhale, tuck the hips under, and 1, and there you go. All right, that's good. So one of the reasons why I have a chair in my workouts is because there's always a barrier sometimes between your results and the floor. Some people don't like to go to the floor. But what this does is this keeps us all together. It doesn't matter if you use the chair, if you go to the floor, you can still get results with anything here. So check it out. This first move is gonna be kind of like a crunch. I am gonna bring your hands out to the side, but that's just so you don't use the chair. You really wanna just use your core, okay? Hands up, fingertips behind. Push the elbows back as far as you can. Your first engagement of the core is gonna come when you lift the heels off the floor. As soon as you lift the heels, that should be the first thing to make your abs crunch. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna push off the balls of your feet, come back and lift up, and then you tap the heel, the toes, and then the heels go down. So lift, lift, tap, and down. Now listen as I say this, engage the core, core is engaged even more, you keep the core engaged, and then you can release and really push the elbows back, which is really gonna help your upper back, which I like to call your back abs. Okay, so here we go, let's do a few. And remember, the engagement comes at the very first heel lift. Engage the core. I almost want you to, as you lift the heels, exhale, squeeze, lift up, in and down. And so what I want you to do is if you can hold it up there just for a couple seconds, instead of just trying to rush through it, hold it up so you can engage. And to give yourself a little bit of extra oomph, touch your stomach while you're up there, bring your hands down so you can feel your abs working. Engage and down. You think I'm crazy, don't you? But I am, so it doesn't even matter. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do, I'm just gonna push my chair back a little bit here. We're gonna do switch kick punch in the chair. So first thing I want you to do is extend your front leg, extend your back arm, kind of like martial arts. Pull that front elbow into your side, pushing through. Now remember, just like with that running lunge, both feet are off the ground at the same time, but you're constantly engaging. Now this is the one exercise where I do want you to try and take it a little bit faster, because you're gonna start to feel the burn in the hip flexors, which happens a lot whenever you're doing abs. So they have to get strong too and they have to work. So for about 30 seconds, you can do it fast, and in 30 seconds, you can do it slow. Just make sure you have control. And then last but not least, and this is one of my favorite moves here because it involves your obliques. Just gonna put the chair down. We're going into a plank position on the chair. And so you take your feet shoulder width apart, you bring your back leg to your left front elbow, and then you come down. Front leg to back elbow and push. Making sure you squeeze the core and the obliques every single time. So breathe through, exhale on the work. Make sure you really protect your lower back. Don't put your butt in the air. So you can go, give me three more reps here. Here's three, and back, head in neutral spine, looking down towards your chair. Really exhale, and one. Slowly walk the feet in and come up. All right, so do each of these seven ab moves for 1 minute. Shawn Week is underway and you can do it there too. But make sure if you do this again, you do each move for 1 minute, you move slow and controlled, you use your core, and do the best that you can do. My name is Shawn T. Peace out.